Hello and welcome to New Filmmakers Los Angeles in partnership with MovieMaker magazine. My name is Danny DeLillo and we're here at the South Park Center and I'm here with Rakefet with her movie Boo. Let's take a look at a clip.
Keeps you from doing worse things.
7 years without drinking.
Hey, keep coming back, because it works if you work it.
Thank you so much for being here today.
Thanks for having me.
And congratulations on your film, and congratulations for scaring me. It worked.
Good. That's the point.
For those that haven't seen it, tell us a brief synopsis.
Boo is about a girl who just got her 7 year sobriety chip, and is having kind of a rough night, and she has a unfortunate encounter with somebody, and through flashbacks we kind of find out what happened, and it's kind of a story about addicts and choosing between what they love and who they love.
I couldn't believe that you took on so many amazing roles, though, both on camera and also behind the scenes as well, which is amazing.
Yes.
Tell us, where did this story get inspired by?
My boyfriend at the time told me this story about this friend he was picking up who was freaked out, and he got in the car and wouldn't tell him anything, and he was just flipping out, and it turns out that he saw some weird guy doing weird things. I don't know. Anyway, it kind of, I don't really know where it came from, and yeah. I did this last night at the Q&A too. I'm not entirely sure, but he told me this story, and it just kind of inspired me to write this story about addiction in a kind of different way. And I was like, how can I make a horror movie about addiction? And that's how it came about.
And as I say, you wrote this and directed it and then also starred in it as well.
And produced.
I mean, honestly, it's like a quadruple threat.
I did.
amazing. Your performance was amazing, and I went through so many emotions with character. I was very angry, I was very sad, and then you're extremely funny as well.
Thank you.
How was that experience for you taking on all those roles?
It was hard. I mean, my last film, Jackson Love, I wrote, produced, and starred in, but I didn't direct. Uh-huh. And so this one was like an added stress. But it was pretty cool. It was just, when I'm crying in the movie, I mean, I was really crying.
Yeah.
That was like producer crying.
Oh.
That was like, I'm exhausted and we've had 3 overnights in a row.
Yeah.
And, I'm in charge of everything.
Yeah.
And it was very stressful, especially we had special effects makeup. That day was very stressful. It took a long time to put on. It was very uncomfortable to wear. And I was trying to direct and I couldn't see because I had contacts and I couldn't see with.
Oh, you poor thing.
It was difficult.
I was gonna ask you what the biggest challenge was, but there were certainly challenges there.
There were a few.
You did 3 overnight shoots, didn't you?
We did in a row.
How was that experience? Like being jet lagged all the time?
Yeah, I mean, I tried to the couple days before change my sleep schedule, but it didn't really work.
Yeah.
And so the first day was the worst, and I even had some crew people fall asleep like in the middle of the shoot, they went to sit down and pass out on the couch.
There you go.
But it was hard because they were 12-hour days, 6 p.m. to 6 a.m., 3 days in a row, and I was there 2 to 4 hours before and 2 hours after,
mm-hmm.
cleaning up and wrapping and whatever, setting up and putting makeup on and whatever. So it was just I was pretty dead at the end.
I'm sure you
were. I lost my voice. It was,
But you must, I mean, obviously, I felt you must have had a really good team with you because
I did.
Obviously, it all worked out wonderfully well as well.
I did. Ned Thorne, who is my editor, also was on set kind of helping me direct because I couldn't do every single thing all at once.
Yeah.
And so he was kind of being my extra pair of eyes and helping me with some yelling of action and cut because I was crying or I was in character and I was you do it.
Yeah.
And so that was really helpful. And we had a great DP, Alex Griffin, who is just the nicest guy and really talented.
It was, very beautiful.
He's very good. And he didn't lose his cool. We didn't have our equipment the first night and he didn't even lose his cool then, like, he's just very steady, a steady person, and I would use him anytime.
It's amazing about, speaking of editing as well, like, particularly in a horror film, it's got to be so specific to kind of get those scares, get those moments, and it was really well edited as well.
Thank you. Yeah, Ned is an amazing editor. He edited my last film, Jackson Love, also, and he actually fixed a lot of that film because we didn't get the coverage we needed for certain things, and he kind of, in the editing room with me, figured out a way around some of the stuff that we didn't have, like what we needed for. But having your editor on set while you're shooting is amazing.
It's
because
key.
He's watching it and he's literally kind of cutting it in his head as we go. And he's like, we need this, we didn't have this, we need this shot, we need this. Like, so that was really helpful to have him there.
And you on camera are amazing. Like, your character was amazing to watch. Like,
thanks.
Really, really amazing. And I just couldn't believe what you went through in a short film, like a lot.
It was a lot of crying.
Yeah.
It was a lot.
From a producer perspective and a character
perspective. Yeah. There was on and off screen tears. There were.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
And what was it? I mean, because again, when you've got to, like, you know, I don't want to give anything away for those who haven't seen
it. Yeah, that's why I don't want to say too much.
You don't want to say too much. You got to watch it. But at the same time, there was obviously makeup involved. What was, you know, how do you go about making that in a short film? Who was your team? What was the experience?
So our makeup artist, her name's Renee Goodhue. She's really fabulous and talented, and she worked on a horror called Echoes of Fear that did really well last year, and I was referred to her from that filmmaker. Mm-hmm. And we kind of designed the makeup together, the look of it and how we want it to be, and we did a whole test makeup day. So I did a 7-hour day just trying on all the makeup and seeing how long it was gonna take. It was a 5-hour application. In the end, 4 to 5 hours. So I came 3 to 4 hours early on one of the days to, like, get started on that. So that was, it looked great though, I think.
So going through, it did look fantastic,
thanks.
It really did. So going from the perspective of writing, directing, producing, and starring in, what have you learned from that experience?
Don't do all of it? No.
actually, great.
No, I'm definitely, and probably anybody on my crew would agree, I'm a little bit of a control freak, and I like things to be the way I envision them. And so it was nice to have all the hats because I didn't have to really defer to anybody.
Yeah.
And it really was my vision, my shots, my look, my colors, my costumes, I picked everything.
Yeah.
So I do like that about it, but it's also like everything falls on you.
Yeah.
So even if I had a great team and everyone did stuff to help, but in the end, if they were too busy or they got a job or they were tired or they were whatever, guess who?
You got to keep the energy up, haven't you? Yeah.
I had to do it, right?
Yeah,
And I did a whole crowdfunding campaign before, which was a job in and of itself.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I would say make sure you have a good team. Like, I had Ned there, which was really helpful.
Mm-hmm.
I had a really good DP that I didn't have to, like, I didn't have to worry about him. Like, I knew he knew what he was doing. We had a great gaffer. She's an excellent gaffer. And we had 50% women on our crew, actually more than that, I think. And we tried to hire diversely and females and give people opportunities that maybe, like, weren't getting the opportunities to do certain jobs.
I love that. Now, what was, for your film, when it's put in front of an audience, I'm sure you just love just hearing the reactions. So what was it like at New Filmmakers LA with in front of your audience? What was that experience like when they watched your film, Boo? Because I was hearing the squirms and the screams and the twists and the turns. What was that like?
Okay, you guys have the best audience. I've only screened it in front of, I think, four. We've had four screenings so far. And this was by far the best audience.
Aww.
And they were vocal and they just made me, they did everything I wanted them to do. Like, there was gasps and it seemed like, and you could tell when the whole audience understood what the twist was. It happened at the same time, it seemed like, for everybody, which was really nice to hear. So it was pretty cool.
It was the
best audience I've seen it with. Like, they were the most vocal, and that makes it really, it makes me proud of it.
Yeah, well, thank you, New Filmmakers audience. Come back anytime.
Thank you.
What's next for you?
I'm writing a couple features because I'm done making shorts.
Yep.
And I would like to turn Boo and my last short into a series.
Yes, that's what I want to hear.
Thank you. That's great. Yeah, I want to make, I'm hoping that one of the people I met at the networking thing yesterday might be able to help me develop those, because I don't know that much about TV, but I think that they would make great one-hour series.
Yeah.
I love that. Yeah, I don't want to produce anymore.
No, okay. Let it go.
I mean, I might, but directing I love, writing I love, and acting is number one for me.
That's, I love it.
That's what I really, really, really love.
But what I really, really love also about you is that you just, you know, you're trying and doing successfully, giving everything a go and understand different parts from writing, directing to producing, and even if that's not you want to do, the fact that you've done it, I think it's so important to understand all the roles, isn't it?
And for sure. You know? Yeah, I mean, especially because I came up as an actress mostly, and I didn't know really what a director did other than when I saw him or her.
Yeah.
And I didn't really know what a producer did, and I didn't know what it took to really finish a screenplay, and now I do, and I have a lot more respect and just understanding of those positions, which I think anybody working in this business should be working in every possible department that they can.
Yeah.
At least once.
Yeah.
Like, I was a PA, I worked in casting, I was wardrobe, I worked in makeup, I did AD work, I was an extra. I mean, like, I've done pretty much almost every job except for grips and gaffers, because I don't know anything about that.
Yeah. Those talented bunch. Yeah,
I don't know how they do it.
I have no idea how these guys do it.
And honestly, I got a C in cinematography in film school, so that wasn't really for me either.
Oh, but hey, but it's all about exploring and finding where you feel like you fit the most.
Yeah,
you know,
the creative stuff.
So what piece of advice have you had, or maybe you go by as a filmmaker, that you can maybe share with our audience?
Piece of advice, it's really important who you choose to work with, because you have to trust them, and also they have to be kind people. I don't want to work with egos, and I don't want to work with people who are just not nice people.
Because
I would rather hire someone who is inexperienced but really sweet and hardworking than someone who has a ton of experience and is just not a nice person.
I love that.
And yeah, so I think picking your team and really knowing them, and not just like picking them off of a resume or even a recommendation, like meet with them, talk to them, see if you guys vibe, because a movie set is already stressful, and even your best friend on a movie set can easily not be. Because everybody is stressed and tired and it's hard.
Yeah.
So the more you can surround yourself with people who are really just nice people and good people and want to work hard and do things and are there because they love it, like, it's better. I mean, I
love that, and I don't think we hear that enough from people, because that's exactly how I feel as well. Like, it's not hard to be kind. I know it's hard and stressful at times, but you know, we're all in it together, we're a team.
Yeah, and we didn't have a lot of money, obviously, because nobody does. And so I couldn't pay people what they were worth, for sure. But for me, I was like, look, if you're doing this for the paycheck, don't do it.
Yeah.
Because it's not going to be much of a paycheck.
Yeah.
Do it because you want to make something, or you believe in me, or you like the script, or you think that it's going to be a fun thing to do, or add to your life in some way. Mm-hmm. And don't do it for the money, because there isn't any. Yeah. Don't do any of this for the money.
Yeah.
There's no money. At least not yet.
And even when you do it for the money, it's, you know, you have to work really hard, so it doesn't stop either way anyway.
And
so
you just have to be nice.
Yeah.
I just want people to be nice
Everybody.
Be nice,
okay? No, I love that. All the egos can disappear. It's all good. I'm happy about that too.
Yeah.
Listen, thank you so much for being here.
I want to
see more of you in front of camera and behind camera, so please keep delivering more. And I'm so glad that you're looking at Boo into a TV series, because I think I just want more.
Yeah, so, I want to follow, you know, different addicts. It'll be fun.
Yeah. So please give us more. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Everybody watch Boo. Boo, boo, boo.
You go to meetmyboo.com. You can see more pictures and behind the scenes and follow up for screenings and stuff like that.
Meetmyboo.com. Not my boo, her boo.
There you go.
Thank you.